Right, health and safety when fiberglassing. This is something that often gets talked about and commented on, because I just don't wear that much PPE. Personal protective equipment. You expressly do not want that in your eye. That's why I pour it in from a height. Not in my eye. No need for me to wear eye protection. I do have little burn marks on my skin. That's why I would suggest to you to wear full protection. This is built up over years, yeah? On deeper ponds than this, where the resin splatters down off the rollers. Now, James asked me the other day if fiberglass is bad for you, because the smell gets pretty horrific. Refer back to the first time I did James's first pond. Well, the only time I did James's pond, I didn't go back and re-fiberglass it. Check back to his first video, where James had a go in the pond with me, yeah? His eyes were watering, he'd got snot pouring out of his nose, his eyes were burning. I took him to the dark side, and he didn't want to ever go back. That's why he asked me to go down and fiberglass his new pond for him. He didn't want none of that smoke again. And he did ask me, I don't know if my response has made the edit or not, but he did ask me if fiberglass is bad for you, the smell, yeah? I said to him, well, you know, I tough it out. When the vapors get too much, I just get out and take a break, get some fresh air, yeah? But to really cleanse the toxins out of my system after a day's glassing like yesterday, 8 hours in here, yeah? Or an 8-hour shift. The vapors were getting a little bit heady, let me say. I had some vivid dreams last night in the back of that van. Now, the way I get rid of those toxins out of my body that have been breathed in, like I'm doing right now, because I'm not wearing a mask, yeah? Good luck wearing a mask in any kind of temperature. Especially in confined spaces, smaller ponds than this. Right. We'll just let that floor drop. You know what wetting out now is, don't you? Because I've explained it a few times. Yeah, I'll just let that wet out while I'll explain how I combat the toxins that build up in my body, in my lungs and in my bloodstream, yeah? Over the course of a shift of a job, yeah? 3.5 days are going to be here. Basically, in the back of my van, and I've got one at home for shorter distance jobs, yeah? I've got an oxygen tent. So, for that 8 hours I did in the pond yesterday, it wasn't exactly 8 hours, it was 8 hours of a shift, all told. I probably did 5 hours of fiberglassing. That was from that window round to that corner over there. See the other video from yesterday, last night. Now, because I spent 5 hours glassing, I did my calculations according to the doctor's recommendations for the oxygen tent. And last night, I spent half of the fiberglassing time, so 5 hours divided by two, 2.5 hours in my oxygen tent with my oxygen bottle set with the regulator at the right flow rate, purifying the toxins out of my body, yeah? I've also got one of these oxygen tents at home for shorter jobs, shorter distance jobs, where I'm not staying overnight. And that is built in to my, with Velcro, onto my Lazy Boy chair. And I've got like a clear window in the front of it, so I can sit there in my oxygen tent, having all the toxins withdrawn, pulled out of my body into a bottle, right, that I just pour away. And I can just sit there messing about on my phone, watching my Netflix or my YouTube or whatever I do overnight, you see. And then when all the toxins are got rid of, I just simply unzip the oxygen tent. That falls back onto the floor, ready for reuse on the next job. And that's why, because I spent time in the oxygen tent last night. The customer will vouch for this. I was in this pond at 7 o'clock in the morning. If I hadn't have been in that oxygen tent for 2.5 hours last night, I don't know what time I would have got up, because I'd have been feeling all these chemicals in me still. So, if you are having a go DIY, follow all the labels on all your containers and all your materials, yeah? This isn't a do as I, what's that saying? Don't do as I do, not do as I say, or something. I know the risks. I know my abilities with the material. I'm not getting caked up with it. I'm not going to be scratching my skin with dirty gloves. Look at that. Barely anything on me. Nothing on my arms. Champion. I also further reduce my time in the oxygen tents, whether they're in the van or at home. Just by using that little fan there, I can cut the time spent down in the oxygen tents by about 25%. Just by tickling some air in. Hey, up! You all right? A parcel, okay. That was funny. When the parcel delivery guy came down, I says, I turned the camera off. I says, I can't get out now, I'm doing this, yeah? He said, that smells strong. That's 20 metres away up there. He opens the gate and he's come down. He's got one of them snood things on over his face like that. He said, that stinks. I said, I gave him a name and, you know, M. Williams signed for. I'm like, don't get hanging around here, mate. You'll be in my oxygen tent in the back of the van. Get yourself off, lad.